can't go to church, and this is their church. And it's really important that people pray for the station and pray for the people that come back and forth and stuff. They'll have mercy of getting back and forth. And we'd like to say that we all love the Lord, and that's why we're going and singing. I just want you all to remember WLJC and remember us in your prayers. Thank you.
WLJC welcomes you to have church with us for the next 90 minutes during the Hour of Harvest. Call in your prayer request or praise report now. The WLJC prayer team is standing by to talk and pray with you. We have some very special musical guests here this evening to share in song the good news of the gospel. So sit back, relax, sing along, and join in with us as we pray for you and the needs of all our viewing audience. Hour of Harvest is touching countless souls from the Appalachian Mountains to the Bluegrass region, across the nation, and around the world. Live from our studios in Beattyville, Kentucky, here is your host of the Hour of Harvest, Margaret Drake.
Good evening and welcome to another service from our WLJC studios in Beattyville, Kentucky. We hope that you'll stay with us. Weather-wise, we've all been blessed with a good day, and the temperature just being right. We still have a few things to cause some allergy problems, but other than that, well, it's been a beautiful day. So times are changing. It won't be long till we'll be wishing we had some of the warm weather. But anyway, tonight we're starting a new week, and we trust that you'll stay with us. We have a lot of things going on here at the ministry, and we're looking forward to our revival and telethon coming up in October. And so you'll be helping us pray for that, will you? Well, we want to welcome each of you, and we want to share some scripture, and then we have a lot of good singing, we hope. And Dottie has phone operators up there. They'll take time to listen to you and pray for you, and so we will see some good things from the Lord tonight. We'll go back to the Psalms tonight. Psalms 111. It says, "Praise ye the Lord. I will praise the Lord with my whole heart in the assemblies of the upright and in the congregation. The works of the Lord are great, sought out of all them that have pleasure therein. His work is honorable and glorious, and his righteousness endureth forever. He hath made his wonderful works to be remembered, and the Lord is gracious and full of compassion. He hath given meat unto them that fear him. He will ever be mindful of his covenant. He hath shown his people the power of his works, and that he may give them the heritage of the heathen. The works of his hands are verity and judgment. All his commandments are true. They stand fast forever and ever, and are done in truth and uprightness. He sent redemption unto his people. He hath commanded his covenant forever. Holy and reverent is his name. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. A good understanding have all they that do his commandments. His praise endureth forever." Psalms 111. And there it tells us that the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. And you know how often we see and hear and know that people do not fear God anymore. They totally disregard him, just like because when they do wrong, he doesn't strike them dead like he did Ananias and Sapphira. But you know, he's still keeping records. He's the one that knows everything we say or do or even think. And so he knows about this. And so we've got to remember to have a reverential fear of the Lord. Just think, he's the God that created the whole universe, the whole world. And to think that he knows us so well, and that he takes care for each person. We're not just a big mass production coming through the world, but we are individuals when it comes to his dealing with us. And so that's something we can really be thankful for, that we are individuals. He knows everything, how we are, our personalities, and what we like, what we don't like, or what is a weak spot in her life or what's a strength. He knows all this and He knows how to help us. And so tonight, let's have this reverential fear of the Lord, knowing that He's going to even the score with some of those. Maybe you're battling some things that's been unjustly done to you. This happens really often. But God is going to even the score for His people someday. So let's be true to Him. Let's not miss out on that, because if we turn around and have the same attitude or get in the same position and everything that they're in, then we're going to lose it. You know, remember where the disciples got angry because they was traveling through the country and one place wouldn't sell them anything to eat. And the disciples said, now, talking to Jesus, said, shall we just rain down fire on them and burn them up? And because they were angry, we would have been too. If we get hungry, we get a little out of sorts, don't we? I have one little great-grandkid that talked about how bad they get upset. And I said, well, I know how you feel, honey. I do too. I get unhappy if I'm hungry. And so those disciples was hungry, and they just said, well, let's just wipe them all out. Let's just get rid of them right now, because they wouldn't give us anything to eat. But Jesus said, He just stopped them in their tracks and said, hey, you don't even know what spirit you are of. They was worse than the people that wouldn't sell them food, and because they wanted to destroy Him. But anyway, that's why we need to check in real often with the Lord and say, now what about my attitude? What about my what's in my heart? Is it pleasing to You? The things I think about, the places I go, or how I spend my money, or what is it that we need from the Lord to check, give, you know, make a check mark and help us to know how we need to change? Because that's what helps us grow. If everything we get rid of in our life that's not Christ-like, and you know, sometimes it's a little while getting there, but there's always things that can come up that to try your patience and so forth. But we know what our weaknesses are, and we know when we have to holler a little louder for the Lord to come and help us, because we're not doing too well. But He loves us, and He remembers that we're made out of a little ball of dust, and so he knows how to help us, and I'm thankful for that, aren't you? If He wasn't more merciful toward us than we are toward each other, we'd all be hurting. But I'm glad He is. I'm glad He is. And He loves us. That's the main thing. All right, let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank You for Your mercy. We thank You for Your compassion. We thank You for Your love toward us and Your forgiving spirit, and how You do not condemn us, but You help us to know. You've given us a conscience, and You help us to know when something is done that is wrong. And You and if when we're truly sorry, then You can forgive us and help us get back on the right path. So tonight, Lord, for anyone that has joined us that's having a struggle emotionally or psychologically or spiritually or physically, Lord, You know what level they are and You know how to help them. And I'm so thankful for that. So we just ask You to touch them and let victory come tonight in the hearts of those that need it. We ask You to bless our singers. We ask You to bless Brother Harlan Sexton tonight and his family, and Lord, heal him and help him to be able to continue his ministry in Jesus' name. Amen. All right, we do want to remember Brother Harlan. He's taking treatments and was unable to be with us tonight, so we miss him. All right, we have some folk that have been faithful for a long time to be with us, and the girls don't like for me to tell how long that's been, so we won't. But anyway, they're still pretty girls. And we have the Murphy family from Corbin, and they do have CDs. Call them at 606-515-1670. And is that the right number? Okay, all right, I did something right. All right, let's go to the Murphy family.
Mm-hmm. tried everything, and everything you've tried has failed. You're standing at the harbor, and your ship of hope has sailed. Your friends have no answers, and your peace just can't be found. Oh, but there's a hand of mercy that can turn it all around. When nothing but a miracle will do, there's nothing that the hand of God cannot bring you through. I know He's more than able, and He will deliver you. Darkness, and no one seems to hear. Just because you can see Him, it doesn't mean He isn't near. Perhaps He's only waiting until you've done all you can do. So He's the only thing that's left to hold on to. When nothing but a miracle will do, there's nothing that the hand of God cannot bring you through. I know He's more than able, and He will deliver you. When nothing but a miracle. Trials, when you face the giant of doubt, listen to a crowd of witnesses, you'll hear them crying out. And from a lion's den and a fiery furnace, from the belly of a whale, through prison walls and a hopeless tomb, walks a God that never fails. I can hear old Daniel and Jonah, Peter and Paul. They're shouting with Lazarus, He delivered us all.
When nothing but a miracle would do, there's nothing that the hands of God cannot bring you through. I know He's more than able, and He will deliver you. When nothing but a miracle will do. When nothing but a miracle will do.
Need a miracle today, don't we? The hour that we live in and the shape the world's in, we need a miracle. And you know, I thank God for everything that He does. And the hour that we live in, you know, it looks bad for the world, but for the saints of God, He said, I'll never leave you nor forsake you. I'll go all the way with you, even unto the end of the world. And I know tonight that He's with us. He's here. And He said, where two or three are gathered in My name, I'm one in the midst. And if He's in the midst, I'm sure tonight something good will come out of all this. So I thank God for everything He does. And let's do that one, Tiffany. His name is Jesus. You want to try that one? We'll send this one out to everybody's listening in. If I get to mentioning names, I'll mess up for sure. Go ahead.
Family and friends will let you know.
stand beside you through thick and thin. His name is Jesus, the King of all kings, our Lord and Savior, who died for our sins. Now I was lost in sinking sand. I had no one to take my hand, but when I called upon his name, he reached below the bottom for me that day. 'Cause I've been hurt more than I can stand, just as much as any man, but when I saw his crown of thorns, I couldn't complain anymore. His name is Jesus, the King of all kings, our Lord and Savior, who died for our sins. Suffered pain and agony just so that we could be set free. And when they nailed him to that tree, you know he done it all for you and me. Yes, I'm gonna serve him till I die. I'm gonna keep him close by my side. And when I leave this world behind, I'll see my Savior on the other side. His name is Jesus, the King of all kings, our Lord and Savior, who died for our sins. Our Lord and Savior, who died for our sins. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Truly love the Lord. You know, we go through things and we wonder why, but the Lord is always there. He tells us in His Word that He would never leave us nor forsake us, go all the way with us, even unto the end of the world. And with a promise like that, we can't fail. The whole world may stand against us, but the Lord will give us strength to come through it all. But I truly love the Lord and thank Him for everything that He does. And glory to God. Well, I was looking to see what song we're doing next, so... We thank God for everything He does. Glory to God. Y'all pray for me. Every time I get in front of these cameras, I get nervous and can't think of what I'm going to say next. And the next thing I know, boy, I'm just sticking my foot in my mouth. But anyway, we love the Lord. Y'all pray for us. Go ahead, T.
Prayed for the day that God would give him a son. Blessed Isaac was his name, the greatest gift. Again.
justified is in Him. God wanted me. Most of us, I dare to say, we have an Isaac in God's way, and all this all to God will prove it's not your.
Till I hear from heaven. You know, sometimes we make mistakes. Sometimes we get the flesh in the way and troubles come and we wonder why. And we think that the Lord won't help us. We think the Lord won't forgive us. And buddy, the Lord's just standing there with open arms because He knows life is just tough and we make mistakes. And He said He's just to forgive and He'll always make a way where there seemeth to be none. And He said that His grace was sufficient. So whenever we make a mistake and we stumble along the way, that's where His grace comes in. So we thank God for His amazing grace and everything that He does. Glory to God. Go ahead, Tiff. you, Lord. I want to send every song that we do out to the church over at Bogletown, over into Somerset. They're listening in tonight. We've got some people listening in up in Detroit, Brother Billy Joe. They watch us on the internet, and got some people down in Tennessee tuning us in tonight. And there was someone else told me they were listening close to Missouri. They said they was going to tune us in tonight. So we thank God for everybody that's listening in, and send it over to Brother David over there at Somerset and the church there at Shady Grove or whatever it is, Beach Grove, I think it is, but I get them mixed up, Sister Margaret. But anyway, we want to send this next song out to them, and it's especially for the folks at Bogletown. They like this one a lot. I'm going to a place so fair, there'll be no pain. We're going to be at New Vision Pentecostal Church in Richmond Saturday night and Sunday morning, Sunday night of this week, this weekend coming up. and want to invite everybody out to come be with us. And I don't know if the girls will get to be there Sunday morning, but they'll be there Saturday night and Sunday night. And I got to go back Sunday morning and preach for them and maybe try not to run too many of them off. But anyway, we love the Lord and thank Him for everything that He does. And we'll send this song up there to New Vision. And the train song. Lord help me. Do you know which train you'll be riding? Do you know which train you'll be on? There's a long black train bound for nowhere, but the train I'm on is bound for home. That long black train is the devil, and he's stealing men's souls every day. Great fame and fortune, but one day it'll all fade away. Do you know which train you'll be riding? Do you know which train you'll be on? There's a long black train bound for nowhere, but the train I'm on is bound for home. Now this train I'm on is bound for glory. Some call it that sweet Beulah land, where there's peace and love everlasting, and Jesus will be the light of that land. Do you know which train you'll be riding? Do you know which train you'll be on? There's a long black train bound for nowhere, but the train I'm on is bound for home. Now the choice is yours for the making. Time's running out, can't you see? Come and get your ticket for glory. Come ride this train with me. Do you know which train you'll be riding? Do you know which train you'll be on? Cut it short on the end of that one. Lord, we thank you tonight for everything. Praise the Lord. Do another one here that I wrote. It's been a while back, and I couldn't finish it for a long time, and finally got the last words to make it work, so we'll try that one tonight. Do you know the pain? Do you know the pain? Like no one really loves you. Do you know the hurt? Like no one even cares. Even in a room full of people, you're all. Same way when they nailed him to that old cross. Come unto me, all ye heavy laden. Come unto me. Just trust in me, for I truly love you, and I proved it all upon Mount Calvary. This whole world is filled with grief and sorrow, and sometimes, oh, the pain, it gets so hard to bear, but that's why he went to the Father to send us the Comforter. And if we don't faint, oh, the Lord will be right on time. Come unto me, all ye heavy laden, come unto me, and I will give you peace. Just trust in me, for I and I proved it all upon Mount Calvary. Yes, I proved it all upon Mount Ain't no grave gonna hold my body down. Well, ain't no grave gonna hold my body down. When I hear that trumpet sound, gonna get up out of that ground, cause there ain't no grave gonna hold my body down. I'm going down to the river of Jordan. I'm gonna bury my knees in the sand. I'm gonna holler high hosanna until I reach that promised land. Well, meet me, Jesus, I'll be back. Oh, meet me in the middle of the air. And if you please compel me, Lord, I won't need no other prayer. I thought there ain't no grave I'm gonna hold my body down. Well, ain't no grave give up out the dance ground, cause there ain't no grave I'm gonna hold my body down. Well, you can take me down to the graveyard, lay my body down. When old Gabriel blows that trumpet, honey, I'm gonna come up out the dance ground. Well, meet me, Jesus, or meet me. Oh, meet me in the middle of the air. And if he swings you bell, me, Lord, I won't need no other part, cause there ain't no grave gonna hold my body down.
Thank you very much. The Murphy family. I thought that always had to be the last one in case they ran out of wind, but they're going to take a chance on doing it in the middle of the program. But anyway, the Murphy family, we're always glad to have them. They have CDs for sale, 606-515-1670. They'll take them a little break, and then they'll be back with some more good songs. We have from West Virginia, there's a young lady, Morgan, and she's a student at the Alice Lloyd College. And 3 weeks ago, she was in a car accident, and she's in critical condition. So I want everyone to pray for that. And a little baby, only 3 months old, named Noah, has had 10 seizures and has been rushed to the UK hospital. And that's from Lee County. From Lincoln County, Willie, Julie has called for Willie that is suffering physically. Cleo has called for Nina from Perry County, is having gallbladder surgery in the morning. Sophia from Paintsville for Derek that has pancreatitis and only 20 years old and is in a lot of pain. Wilma has called for healing for her body. Julie has called for Donna that needs help. Paul from Lincoln County has had some tests done and wants to pray that they come back and that he's okay. Goldie has called for herself and her husband from Mount Sterling. Betty from Clark County, her husband's niece has colon cancer and is in ICU. And that's his first cousin. All right, our friends up in Ohio, that the wife has neuropathy and suffering a lot. So they have called tonight and need prayer. So we'll remember them. And Geraldine from Knott County for a daughter that has different problems. Here's Luther has called from Wayne County for Bethany Rose that, thank you. Bethany Rose, Mr. and Mrs. Robert Foster's granddaughter wanted a song, but someone in that group has cancer. I'm not sure how that read. But anyway, from Manchester, Addie has been in a car accident and praying for her healing. Anna Margaret from Pike County is very sick and praying for a miracle. Well, that's exactly what we asked for. And you know, the biggest miracle we'll ever see is that of when someone gets saved, accepts the Lord, the change that comes in their life. That's the biggest miracle that you'll ever see. That's one that nobody can explain, but it happens. All right, Lucille Phelps from Somerset wanted Brother Murphy to sing her a song. Her birthday, at her birthday, she will be 92, and she wanted a song for her birthday, Lucille Phelps. Sandy is enjoying the music. Francis from Montgomery County, can't walk, has a broken bone, I guess. I want someone to sing Kneel at the Cross, loves the old hymns. Deborah from Fayette County for herself, her right eye is, well, I'm not sure. There's something wrong with her eye, and I think Dottie's getting in a hurry up there tonight. But anyway, there's a lot of calls coming in, so just be patient if she doesn't get them all. Faye has called for Rebecca from West Virginia. She called in for prayer 2 weeks ago for her daughter to get a job, and God has given her a job. So that's a praise report, a praise report. From Lexington, Dora, thanks everyone for prayers for her friend that's in Goshen, Indiana, and she loves the Murphy family. Bertha from Richmond for her children, grandchildren, great-grandchildren, Floyd County. Regina for herself and her husband. They're having some physical problems there. Bernie from Lily for Ray that is in Tennessee. He has cancer and pneumonia and his own oxygen. Pauline from Winchester for Marie was taken from the nursing home to the hospital last night. All right, lady from Knott County has broken her foot, splint on it, and a boot's on that foot. Well, that's a bad situation to try to walk in. A friend for Bobby of Manchester, Bonnie of Manchester, Geneva from Whitley County, Hattie from Manchester, had problems from a car accident. Clark County for Juanita, surgery on Wednesday for gallstones. And for Joey, her son from Clark County. This one is for a nephew, Keith, had a brain aneurysm and heart problems. This one is for Anna, David from, I'm not sure. They just need, and several there, they all need a touch from the Lord. An uncle has called for Josh that's in UK hospital, waiting for heart surgery with a blood clot on the brain. These are some big requests, but we're sharing these because we know a lot of you are going to go to praying right now when you hear some of these that you can identify with and you know they're in trouble. When someone has a aneurysm on the brain or something else like this, that is serious. A family from Tennessee, Jean Ann, Martha, and also this son, Robert from Pulaski County, back surgery on Wednesday from Round County. Roy has called for Mr. Rivers, mother and wife from Knott County has requested prayer for some folk in her family. From Whitley County, Bernice just needs prayers because she's a diabetic. Nicole from Corbin, her cousin's house burned and they need prayer and they also need salvation. This one is from Morgan County for Millie, for mom and a grandmother that needs strength. From Pike County, really enjoying the program tonight and loves the singers. Lena has called for a brother from Somerset, 91st birthday yesterday. He listens, he's 9 years old. Granddaughter got saved and prayed for her family. Norman from McCrary County, bad back problems and needs prayer. Grace from Knox County, sinus and bladder infection. And Eddie from Leslie County, a grandbaby having seizures and also for a lost family. Well, these requests are really important, and I know some of you are going to start praying already, and we'll be praying during service, and at the end we'll agree in prayer with you. All right, the Murphy family has bounced back, and they're ready to sing some more. That curvy road, we hope how soon they get that big straight highway through here, and that the girls won't have such time getting here. But let's return now to the singing of the Murphy family.
My fault. I didn't know what song we was going to sing first. So y'all forgive me. But anyway, love the Lord and thank Him for everything He does. And, you know, my heart was going out to that little fella that was having the seizures. And I know what that is all about because my girls have had them for such a long time. And Stephanie's had one here just a week or so ago. She had a seizure. And so we know all about that. And our hearts and our prayers goes out to that family. And each one of them that's got needs upon the request and everything, you know, we know all about those heartaches and those trials and the things that we have to go through in this life. But it's good to know that the Lord is there and He'll take care of it and He'll be with us through it all. And I know that the Lord is surely there to make a way and to help us get through another day. Glory to God. Okay.
Well, sometimes I get so weary traveling this old road. I cry, Lord, please come and help me bear this heavy load. But in the stillness of the night, He comes along and makes my Lord oh so light. Heaven be worth the journey when I get there. There's been times I've been tested, I've been tried. And many times I've had the victory, but sometimes I fail. But when I start to get down along the way, oh, something in my soul begins to say, don't hold on.
Thank you, Lord. Give me a D there. We'll do that. Wake me up. We'll do wake me up. Oh, wake me up. Wake me up when the trumpet sounds. Wake me up, sweet Jesus, when this old world is burning down. All I have is troubles and trials in this wicked world below. Wake me up, sweet Jesus, I want to walk the streets of gold. Oh, wake me up when it's all over. Wake me up when the trumpet sounds. Wake me up, sweet Jesus, when this old world is burning down. This old world is so wicked, I know it cannot stand. Wake me up, sweet Jesus, by the touch of your hand. Oh, wake me up when it's all over. Wake me up when the trumpet sounds. Wake me up, sweet Jesus, when this old world is burning down. When this old world is burning down. Thank you, Lord. Now some seek old wealth down here, some for fame. I look for Jesus, with him I'll reign. I'm just a pilgrim here, soon I'll be gone. Nothing can hold me here, I'm heading home. I said now nothing can hold me here, I'm heading home. Heavenly gates are near, it won't be until I'm walking on streets of gold, and I'm singing around God's throne. Nothing can hold me here. I'm heading home. Now if I should die down here, for that trumpet sound, when they lay my body in the cold, cold ground, you don't have to cry for me. Don't sing no sad song. Nothing can hold me here. I'm heading home. I said now nothing can hold me here. I'm heading home. Heaven may get too near. It won't be long until I'm walking on streets of gold. And I'm singing around God's throne. Nothing can hold me here. I'm heading home. I tell you, we're pulling some songs out of the hat, and we're trying to just make them work, and it's kind of ain't working. But we thank God for it tonight anyways. And, you know, we go through a lot of things, and all that's required of us is that we do our best. And when we do our best, the Lord will take all that into consideration, and he'll make the mistakes good. So I thank the Lord. And she wanted me to do this one song, and I also got another request I'd forgot about, but we'll get it later. But there are some people that are watching tonight, and they love that one song, Lord, I Need You. So we'll do this one, and then we'll do that one, okay? Okay. All I can do is my best. I know that God will do the rest. When my burdens and my trials causes me to sway, I'll kneel down and pray. Prayer is a key that will unlock the door to the Master's heart, so I won't worry anymore. I don't believe that Christians this world today should let the trials and troubles take their happiness away. As long as God is with you, have nothing to fear. And you shouldn't get discouraged, and you shouldn't shed a tear. All I can do is my best, and I know that God will do the rest. When my burden and my trials causes me to sway, I'll kneel down and pray. Prayer is a key that will unlock the door to the Master's heart. I won't worry anymore. I won't worry anymore. I guess when you get old, it catches up with you.
I can't sing, Lord, I
need you. Lord, I need you. Lord, I need you to be my friend. Lord, to cleanse me from all my sins. Lord, I need you more than a friend. Lord, please hear my cry. Oh Lord, please don't pass me by. Lord, I need you. Lord, I need. Thank you, Lord. I was thinking about the little lady is going to be 92 years old, and she wanted us to do a song for her birthday. And you know, there ain't no blessed song that anyone can really sing for anyone's birthday other than happy birthday. But you know, we can take a song and just send it out to her and just let her know that we appreciate her, and we want her to know that we care, and we just thank the Lord for it. You got one there, T? Yeah, do that one.
Strength from day to day.
Thank the Lord for everything He does, and we thank y'all for letting us come into your home and sing a song for you and testify about the good Lord above. And one day it'll be worth it all whenever we reach that city. And we thank God for everything that He does, and we just thank God. Okay, go ahead, Tiff.
Appreciate all the good songs by the Murphy family tonight. I think they've done better than even the last time. They do have CDs. You can order them and have them sing for you every day. 606-515-1670. And that'll get you in touch with them, and they'll tell you about their tapes and CDs and so forth. Well, all right. We have more people with birthdays. Here was Okay. All right. We have some new help up here, girls. Your mics are back here behind you. All right. Well, we have Mildred Anderson from Montgomery County has called. His wife is having a 83rd birthday, so happy birthday to all these people. And here's a lady from Floyd County said she's really enjoyed the girls singing tonight. Norma has called for Elmer from McCrary County. Husband has had a bad problem and needs healing. Betty for Pike County having surgery in the morning. And Roy for Lucille from Round County that's in the hospital. Here's someone from Powell County that's had a baby and it's in UK hospital. It cannot eat and the whole family needs prayer. Nora from Floyd County needs prayer for their whole family, it says. And here is a Daniel is only a few days old, a baby. Daniel is having open heart surgery. Just a few days old. That is serious. Another one, a 3-month-old grandson from Montgomery County needs prayer. And from Round County, someone wants in a lot of pain and needs help. Tracy from Floyd County, Barbara from Madison County, Tyler needs prayer. This one is Charlene from Hurley, Virginia for sinus infection and headache. Another one from Floyd County for Willard that's in ICU, had a car accident and needs help there. But here is a praise report. Austin from Casey County and three people in the apartment. Now, where are you girls going?
Get back.
Well, we didn't get the camera on them fast enough, I guess. All right. Well, that's okay. They're tired. They've worked hard and everything today. That's okay. We'll let you go, girls. But thank you anyway. But we do have a lot of calls in here tonight. Russell, I want you to look at there how many. How many. So we'll get you to, I'll reach over here and get this oil and I'll let you anoint them and we'll pray for them. But before we do that, you want to tell again where you're going to be preaching and so forth this weekend?
Yeah, we're going to be at a little church up in Richmond. Well, I guess it's coming out on Irvin Road. Yeah, on Highway 52 there out of Richmond. A new Verizon or something, Pentecostal Church. And we're going to be there Saturday night and Sunday morning, Sunday night. And we're going to, you know, the girls are going to try to be with me. And we just got so many different ones that, you know, we got to go to. We've got to go back to Fort Payne, Alabama. We've got to go to churches just here and there and everywhere. We've been up to Detroit, Michigan. Oh. And the Lord's just opening some doors. And we really appreciate the Lord for that. So that's really been good.
Yes.
And we thank God for it. And so you want us to go ahead and pray over this?
All
right. All right. Heavenly Father, Lord, as we come before you right now, Lord, you know each and every need, each and every heartache, Lord. And God, you know each and every one, Lord, that the prayers, that the requests that they've got before you, and only you, Lord, can help them, Lord, and only you can make a way where there seemeth to be none. And Lord, you said if they would be any two on earth, Lord, that will agree together, as touching anything, believing and asking in the name of Jesus, that it shall be done. And Lord, we're agreeing together, we're agreeing upon your word, Lord, that you are the healer, you are the deliverer. And Lord, we're asking you right now, Lord, just to reach down your mighty hand, Lord, and touch each and every need, Lord, that's in these requests. But Lord, most of all, the ones that are lost, God, we just pray, Lord, that you would send the conviction spirit, Lord, that it would deal with their heart, Lord, and bring them in before it's everlasting too late.
Yes.
Lord, we thank you for the program. We thank you for Sister Margaret. Lord, we thank you for the TV station here, Lord. We just thank you for everything that you do.
Yes.
And Lord, we just pray that you watch over us on the highways home, and we never fail to give you the praise in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen.
So your phone number is, you want to give it yourself?
Yeah, it's area code 606-515-1670. And, you know, they can reach us at that number 24/7 just about. So
we're always willing and ready to take off on another spree or to another church, wherever the Lord would have us to go. Amen. And like I said, we've got to be over at Clark's Chapel over here, a little church just out of Burning Springs here around the 4th of October, and just want everybody to come out and be with us. We sure do.
Okay. Did someone say you're working on another CD?
Yeah, we're in the process of it. This last CD that we made, it was just songs that I wrote, and the girls helped me put that together. And now we're going to make a CD with just the girls on it, and we're going to have a competition, see who sells the most. I think I'm a loser already.
Yeah, you're going to lose it there. Those are pretty girls.
I think I lost that battle.
Yeah, that's not too, that might not be too wise. But yeah. Anyway, the music would be good on both of them, I'm sure. And
oh, yeah.
The girls are always so sweet. And,
yeah.
And same, just like they've always been coming.
Oh, yeah.
Well, we're glad that the Lord is blessing you and helping you and meeting the needs. And you know, we only have this one chance of working for Him.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, sometimes people don't seem to realize that time is so valuable.
Oh yes.
And when our little time here is up, then that's it.
Yeah.
And so we need to be doing everything we can for the Lord right now.
Yeah.
And for anyone that has any ambition to work for Him, they should be doing it, don't you
yes.
think?
Oh, yes. Because it's what we do for the Lord that's going to count.
Yes, only.
You know, we can work hard all of our life. We can get all the riches of this world, and it's going to amount to nothing.
Yes.
But what we do for the Lord, that's what's really going to count. And you know, that's why me and the girls, we travel so much. And you know, we come in sometimes, it's 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning, and Tiffany sometimes she'll just get a couple hours sleep and then she'll get up and go to work. And and you know, I have to say that I'm very proud of my daughters. They both work and they try to do this ministry with me, and we travel just here and there and everywhere, and they're just very faithful to help me. You know, I can say, girls, let's go, but they're ready to go. It's very few occasions that they'll not want to go with me, and then it's because they've had to work or something of that sort, and you know, they're just real faithful. They're good kids. They
yes.
They've been backing me now since they were about what 8 or 9 years old.
Yes, it's very
so about 20 something years we've been on the road, and
yes.
and I've had a lot of health problems, and I've got to go to the heart doctor in the morning over here in Berea, and I'm pretty sure everything's going to be all right. They've told me I've got a heart murmur and it's not beating just right, but you know, I know God's brought me through so many things already. That's just a little thing. I trust Him that He's going to take care of it, and you know, He's there all the time.
Yes.
And I'm sure, Sister Margaret, that when my time is up, there ain't going to be enough doctors to keep me here, because I've been
That's
praying,
true.
Lord, just take me home.
Yes.
When your time comes, the Lord's going to take you. There ain't much can keep you here, but unless the Lord wants you to be.
Yes. But we do need to use wisdom and take
yeah.
as good a care of our bodies as we can.
And
then, like you say, when He really calls us, why, we wouldn't want to stay longer than He
yeah.
wanted us to, because we'd be out of place.
That's
because
right.
if He had a better place for us, then we wouldn't be happy here. So,
oh, yeah.
But that's the good thing about serving God. There is a better place to go.
Oh,
you know, as I read through all those calls tonight, so much pain is represented.
Mm-hmm.
There's broken homes. There was mm-hmm. broken bodies. And,
yes.
and you know, so much pain represented.
Oh, yes.
But to think, I mean, we can't really think about a place where there'll be no more pain. But there is one.
Oh,
and,
there is, yeah.
And we're going.
That's right. He told us in the book of Revelation, chapter 21, there, He said, there'd be a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth were passed away, and there was no more sea. And He talked about that city where there'll be no more pain,
yes.
no more sorrow, no more death, for the former things have passed away. And that's going to be a glorious time
oh,
when we
yes.
can get to that city. Streets of gold, walls of jasper, gates of pearl. We're going to a beautiful city. We sure are.
And we don't want to let anything keep us from it.
No.
There's not anything or anyone on this earth
That's
worth
true.
Losing your soul over.
That's right, yeah.
So remember that. Do what you need to stay true to the Lord and be ready when He calls. All right, looks like our time is come and gone, but we thank the Russell Murphy family for being here tonight. So you pray for them because they are on the road a lot, and these girls are both married and have families, and so they need a lot of prayer covering. And so, well, from all of us here in the studio, we want to say good night and God bless you.
Thank you for being a part of the Hour of Harvest. We hope you get a blessing every time you watch. This program is available for download on your computer or mobile device at www.wljc.com. WLJC is now available on Roku and Google TV. DVD copies of this program are also available for your contribution of $15 or more. The WLJC programs, including the Hour of Harvest, are brought to you through your contributions of support. All contributions made to WLJC are eligible for income tax deduction. Thanks to all who support us. Without you, our programming would not be possible. If you would like to join our mailing list to receive our free monthly newsletter to keep you informed about what is happening at WLJC, along with our monthly musical guest schedule, call 606-464-3600 or write to WLJC, P.O. Box Y, Beattyville, Kentucky, 41311. Want to hear from us faster? Join our email mailing list. You can sign up at WLJC.com. It's easy and it's free. May God bless you.